Contestants, congratulations on surviving Squid Game Battle Number 1. Welcome to Battle Number 2. Today, we find ourselves on an island. You are split into two different teams. Team 1 is Captain Rex, Commander Wolf, Commander Hawk, Commander Thire, and Hardcase. Team Number 2 is Commander Fox, Sergeant Hound, Commander Tethos, ARC Trooper Jesse, and Commander Keller. There are weapons at the center of the island. You are to charge them, pick up arms, and eliminate the enemy team. Good luck, contestants, and may the better clones win.
What's up, gamers? It's your boy, Daily Tactics here, back with game number 2 of the All Clone Trooper Commanders Squid Game, baby. And today's game is going to be a team deathmatch of 5 Clone Trooper Commanders versus 5 Clone Trooper Commanders over here. Clone Trooper Commanders, which we've gone over before, but we'll go over again, is ARC Trooper Jesse, Fox, Tethos, Sergeant Hound, and Keller, the winners of the last Squid Game, as well as we have Hardcase here, who I actually mistook another Jesse for Hardcase. So Hardcase is in this, but he was just wearing different armor last time. That's my bad. I got really confused last game. Wolf, Captain Rex, Thire, and Sergeant... Commander Hawk. Is it Commander Hawk or Sergeant Hawk? I don't know. Leave the comment down below. Either way, there's a bunch of guns in the front here at the cornucopia. All the clones have no equipment except for health packs. They're going to be charging the cornucopia, picking up weapons, and fighting against each other. It should be really, really cool. If you guys enjoy this All Clone Commanders Squid Game, be sure to smash that like button. It is really appreciated. Let's try and get 1,000 likes in the first 24 hours. Subscribe if you have not already. We're trying to hit 350K by the end of the year. And comment down below what you think should be the next game in the next episode of Squid Game here. Either way, guys, let's get into it here. What's up, gamers? I'm here to tell you about Instant Gaming. Instant Gaming is an amazing place where you can get some fire deals on all sorts of video games. Seriously, it's like 60 to 95% off, as you can see here. These are all of the Star Wars titles they have. They literally have every Star Wars title. You can also get XCOM here, Men of War Assault Squad 2, all of the games I play on the channel you can buy here for extremely cheap prices. If you use my affiliate link in the description, it helps me out a ton. So thank you guys for listening to this sponsorship, and thank you to Instant Gaming for continuing to sponsor the channel. Alrighty then, gamers, we're gonna go ahead and press start, and the Clone Trooper Commanders do begin to charge forward on both sides here, exiting the LAATs. I love this, they're running through a little cornfield. The rustle in the bushes, that's very, very cool. These guys mostly split up. These guys very, very bunched together. I would go for the split technique, but maybe some of them are trying to maximize firepower. Both sides getting close to the cornucopia now, and picking up guns. Tethos gets himself a DC-15A right off the bat. Actually, let's go in slow-mo here just to check which weapons each side picked up. DC-15A for Tethos. Sergeant Hound got a DC-17. So did Keller. Bad weapons to pick up right there. Jesse, though, got a DC-15A, and Fox did too, so those are good weapons. Hardcase has a DC-15A. Wolf has a DC-17. Fire, DC-17. Hawk, DC-15C, and then Rex has the same. So a lot more diversity in weapons for team, I guess we'll call this Team Rex over here. He can be team leader. And then over here, let's call it Team Fox. Fox is probably the most prominent member of this team over here. So Team Fox and Team Rex over that way. Let's go into normal speed here. Each clone trooper does have exactly 500 health, which is 5 times the normal health of a normal soldier in Men of War Assault Squad 2, just to make them a little bit more deadly. It looks like the map is glitched a little bit, and we do have some flying turkeys. I guess some force users are manipulating the battlefield to create more obstructions here, which I'm fine with. You know what? If you want to force obstruct some of the battle, then go for it. It makes it a little bit more fun. Sergeant Hound here using these force obstructions to his advantage by firing just underneath a little blockade here. He is taking some hits himself, and they are all hitting in the head because, of course, that's all that is exposed. But you know what? He's doing decently. I would say right now, Rex's team definitely has the better situation going for them. Most of them are exposed, but they're getting the most fire out, and they're only receiving return fire, really, from Tethos over here, as well as Hound. At the moment, Keller is not really participating in the battle. Jesse is covering this flank, but not really firing, and Fox is also covering this flank, but not really in a firing position. So I'd say right now, it is looking like Rex's boys are definitely the dominant force here in this team battle for Squid Game. I'm thinking since this time around, we are doing a team battle, I think the next game that we do is gonna have to be a solo battle. I don't wanna give away any Squid Game spoilers, but they do kind of switch off between team mechanics and solo mechanics. So this is going to be our team battle. Last time it was a solo battle, and then next time I guess we'll do another solo battle again. I think that is definitely gonna be a fun way to diversify the types of games that we are doing here. Either way, I did finally finish Squid Game. It's very, very good. Oh, Hound is dead! Sergeant Hound goes down. If you were rooting for my boy, Rip Rip Potato Chip. By the way, which team are you rooting for? Or if you're just rooting for one singular clone trooper, let me know that as well. But yeah, I did finally finish Squid Game. It was great. I really liked it. I thought it was a really fun, cool TV show. You know, got better as it went on. Interesting concept. And definitely very, very cool. Pretty dark, very dark, in fact, but it was definitely worthy of a watch. I would not recommend it for younger audiences, though. Tethos also going down here. Team Fox is at a massive deficit right now. Their only hope is that maybe Team Rex has taken some serious damage. Oh, yeah, Fire is about to die, actually. And Hardcase has taken some damage, but other than that, not too much damage has gone on for these guys. Right now, Keller is taking some heat, but nothing too crazy. What I'm actually going to go ahead and do is squad up both sides to make them work more as a unit here. Both sides are now squatted up, so if they do make movements and things like that, they'll do it kind of together. Keller here just tanking shots. What are you doing, Keller? Move! Oh my god, this is so frustrating to watch. Why is he just taking shots like this? This is infuriating. Actually infuriating. Let's just speed this up for a second, see if he does anything. Dude, I can't let my boy Keller go down. This is clearly an AI glitch. I'm gonna move him this way. Alright? You know what? I just can't let my boy just take shots without doing anything like that. That is just not fair. Straight up not fair. Oh, I do have to regroup these guys because I did move Keller. Okay. At the moment, the Squid Game is at a bit of a pause, all quiet on the Squid front here. Both sides just sort of chilling at their positions, having a bit of a standoff. They know that if they do die during this battle, they are dead for the rest of the Squid Game. So, despite the fact that one side will win, if that side does take losses, those losses stay. So, for example, if this side does win, Hound as well as our boy Tethos here will remain dead. So they are out of the Squid Game entirely. They are just donezo. That is confirmed at this point. So we are down to 8 Squid Game contestants from the 10 that we started with. Let's go in fast motion here. See if anyone wants to actually make a move. It seems like the AI really just wants to chill at the moment. Anyone? Anyone? Bueller? Bueller? All right, I'm gonna just, in the sake of fairness, I'm gonna let these guys sit here for a little bit. I'll pause recording because they're not doing anything. Nothing is happening. But if any movement happens in the next 5 minutes, I will immediately start recording. If nothing happens in the next 5 minutes, we'll have to move them or something. All right, guys, I've been sitting here in fast motion for about 5 minutes now, and they literally did absolutely nothing. So I think what we're gonna go ahead and do here is actually just delete everyone's cover. I think that's going to be the play. We delete everyone's cover, force them to go into new positions and whatnot. I think it'll be kind of cool, a little bit interesting, a little bit of a dynamic battlefield. Let's go ahead and get it going. Slow motion, breaking up the cover. Now everyone is completely exposed. We can now go back into normal speed here and see what happens. So it seems like Rex's team is now falling back a little bit. Some of their troopers still completely exposed. Fox's team right now more behind cover. Jesse retreated back to get to cover here against these opposing enemies who are now completely exposed themselves. I mean, I was forced to do this. I waited 5 minutes in 5x speed, which is what, you know, a lot more time, 25 minutes or something in-game time, I guess, if that math works out. I don't know exactly if it's 5x speed or if it's 2x speed, but they just call it 5. I don't know what they consider the 5 in the speedometer here, the speedometer for Star Wars Galaxy at War. But either way, I think they weren't going to budge even if I had sat there for 3 hours. I think both sides would have just sat there. So I think this is the most fair way to get things going again, is to just force them into a confrontation by deleting all of their cover. It seems like Rex's team chose not really to backpedal like Fox and Keller's team did. Fox and Keller's team immediately backtracking to available cover, while these guys didn't. They're more exposed, but they are getting more fire out, because not only do they have more teammates left alive from the battle, but in addition to that, them not being in cover is allowing them to get more fire out, because they're not able to get suppressed like the opposing team is. They are able to just sort of stand here and fire. So a little bit of an advantage, a disadvantage type of a thing right there. Fox is not being helpful at all in this game, by the way. He is just sort of sitting there behind a chair, chilling. He is not getting engaged. Jesse over here being an absolute champ, and so is Keller. However, Keller only has that DC-17 pistol, which is just not very helpful in this type of a situation. You know, it's just not super powerful. Of course, you know, Thayer over here has the same pistol, and so does Wolf, but they've got other troopers gunning with them, while Keller really only has Jesse fighting with him, and Fox, who also has a DC-15A, is again not participating in the battle like he should be. I am gonna say I think that this Squid Game is gonna go towards Rex's team. I think Rex's team might go 5-0 here. They might take zero losses in this Squid Game and manage to completely dominate against Commander Fox's team. I do hear a blood-curdling scream, and that would be Keller going down. The second Keller goes down, Fox gets up and starts firing. I do see a little bit of movement over here. Hardcase does choose to move a little bit. So does Rex, actually, moving around just a smidge. Jesse also retreating back to a palm tree over here. I guess the only hope for Fox's team right now is to maybe get another kill, or actually just one kill. But I'm not even sure if that's going to happen. I mean, who was it that was really, really wounded? Was it Hawk? Hawk might have been really wounded. I can't remember. Oh, it was Thayer. Thayer was very wounded. He still is. However, he has healed up a little bit. All sides do have health packs they can utilize, but it looks like he used his and now is no longer super damaged. Fox taking some pot shots at Hardcase here. Hardcase also very, very low health. If he does concentrate on him, he could manage to get a quick little kill here and make it a 4v2, which, while not great, would be a little bit better. It seems like Rex and Wolf and Thayer over there starting to move to the left side a little bit, while these two, Hardcase and Hawk, begin to push forward a little bit more. Fox is doing some healing. That's probably good for him. Jesse over here just sort of pinned down behind this tree. It seems like most shots are missing him, but he does end up going down. Now it is just going to be Fox. It is a 1v5. I think Fox's only hope is to maybe get Hardcase down, but now he's concentrating on Hawk right there. Definitely not the target he wants to be going for if he does want to try and get a kill. I mean, any kill here would be helpful. We have seen 1v5s happen in previous Star Wars tournaments, but I think this one is just about over. Look at this. Rex, Wolf, and Thayer going for the pin here, coming around the flank and just firing on in here. Fox trying his best to take him out, but he is just completely surrounded at this point. Lots more firing going on, but Fox does end up getting clipped right there and goes down. Rex, Wolf, Thayer, Hawk, and our boy Hardcase here all managing to survive this Squid Game alive. They did an amazing 5v5 right there, coming out of it unscathed. Now we have Tethos, Hound, Jesse, Fox and Keller are all out of the Squid Game, and these are the only survivors here. Five troopers go in to the next round. Let me know in the comment section below what you think we should do for the next round in terms of what kind of game we should do. I think it is fun to have a little bit of audience participation. Yo, give me suggestions. I think it could be cool. Someone said one of the Squid Game games, actually, I don't want to spoil it, so I won't say it, but people asked for one particular Squid Game game. However, it's not really possible for me to do it in Men of War Assault Squad 2, so I wasn't able to. But let me know, you know, if it is possible in-game, I'd be more than happy to do it with you guys. Either way, guys, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and comment down below. Peace out. I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Be sure to click that subscribe button for more content, and hit the notification bell if you'd like to be alerted to whenever I live stream or upload. Thanks so much.